today, beginner and advanced techniques which you can use when using the live drawing function, which is really awesome in Adobe Illustrator. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. So today we're going to start with the beginner techniques when using the live drawing method in Adobe Illustrator. We first need to make an artboard, and I'm actually going to use a square one, the measurements being 1200 pixels squared. Stay tuned throughout today's video for the entire tutorial to soak up all of the techniques and the skills for using the live drawing method. Press M for the rectangle tool and then click once on your artboard. We want to make a square slightly bigger than the canvas itself, so I'm going to add 50 pixels onto my already 1200 pixel size artboard. We just want the square to be a stroke with no fill. To align it perfectly, change the align settings to fit the artboard, and then align the square horizontally and vertically. Now press Command R on a Mac or Control R on a PC to open up your rulers, and then bring down a guide exactly halfway down, so in my case here, 600 pixels along the artboard. Once you have two guides like you can see on screen now, press P for the pen tool and then draw a line like so, and this is going to act as a guide. Increase the stroke weight, and then we can change the stroke style to suggest a direction that is pointing, which will become more clearer later. Click on one side of the stroke to change the direction using the pen tool. Now we need the layers window open so we can perform the live drawing function using Illustrator. Click this icon here, which will select every single layer on your document, and then come up to the Effect, Distort and Transform, and Transform option. If we choose to reflect our shape on the X-axis and choose one copy, we can preview the final outcome. Now hide the guide layer that we just made, and now you're going to find that whatever you drew on one section will be mirrored over onto the opposite side. Now this is pretty neat, but there's a lot more to come in today's video. To quickly finish the beginner section of the live drawing function, instead of just using one copy, we can choose to make three copies, and also choose 90 degrees on both the Y and the X axis. By selecting the preview button, we can now see how the reflection will turn out when using the live drawing method. Again, hide the layer and begin your drawing process. You can use the brush tool, you can use the pen tool, and even the shape tools. Everything will be copied and reflected around like so. So for the advanced technique, let's first grab the pen tool and draw a vertical line by holding down Shift. Again, using the Align tool and keeping the alignment related to the artboard, align it vertically and horizontally. This is quite an advanced technique, but follow along and you should be able to perform it for yourself. We're going to transform this line here, but in the transform window, make two copies and set the degrees to 300 degrees. Checking the preview box, we can now see the artboard is split into six different sections. In the layers window, create a new layer, and then lock it down and hide the original layer by clicking the icons. Select the new layer and access the pen tool by pressing P, and draw another vertical line. Like before, align it perfectly on your artboard. Now copy this line with Command or Control C, and then paste a duplicate right over the top with Command or Control F. We're now going to rotate that duplicate by 90 degrees, so we now have two perfectly centered lines on our artboard. Make the original layer visible again in the layers window, and then press B for the brush tool. The mark I'm going to make now is just a guide, like we did in the beginner section, so it doesn't matter if it looks good or bad. Make sure to highlight this layer in the layers window, and then go back to the transform window under the effects section. We will now reflect this over by one copy onto the x-axis, and then hit OK. With the same layer selected, go back into the transform window and click apply new effect. This time, we're going to generate two copies and we're going to use the 120 degrees. And you should end up with something like this. But again, remember, this is just a guide. Now, finally, press P for the pen tool and draw an area that covers 120 degrees, i.e. two sections of the artboard. And you must be really precise with your path, making sure it's on the lines properly. Make sure the layer that we just created is at the very top of all layers in this group. Then apply a clipping mask like so. Now, anything you draw in the top right section where the clipping mask exists will be reflected around the entire design. But the clipping mask actually keeps everything neat and tidy. And stay tuned as I'm going to show you one final addition in today's tutorial. With the same format as before, using the clipping mask, open the brushes menu here and then create a new brush. I'm going to use a calligraphy brush, and I'm going to make the stroke quite large. Now when I go ahead and make my design, you will see how neat this looks. The clipping mask function of the live drawing technique really helps to make some cool designs. If you make a mistake, just press Command or Control Z, and if you didn't fully understand the advanced technique in today's video, just go back and watch it again step by step, recreating it for yourself as you go. It's not too difficult once you go over it a few times. So yeah, I had lots of fun making designs with this technique, and a lot of them I use the calligraphy brushes. There is one final point that you need to take into account, however. Once you have a design, you'll notice that the only part that is selected is the clipping mask section. So go up to Object and Expand, and your design will now be vectorized around the entire 360 degrees of your artboard. So there was my tutorial for beginner and advanced techniques using the live drawing function. If you enjoyed it and found it useful, and you want to keep boosting your skills as a designer, subscribe to Satori Graphics for weekly graphic design content. And also be sure to like and share my content on social media if you want to help out my channel and keep it growing as it is. Make sure to have a great day, everybody, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.